Hello friends, my name is Surendra. Welcome to our channel Chemistry with SK. In this session, we'll discuss about the bomb calorimeter. What is bomb calorimeter? This is the instrument which is useful for determination of calorific value of solid or liquid fuels. It means by using bomb calorimeter, we can determine the calorific value of solid or liquid fuels, and that is the bomb calorimeter. So we'll see. This is very important point. So generally it can be for 5 to 7 marks question. The principle of this method or a bomb calorimeter is, it is assumed that the whatever the amount of heat will be produced by the fuel, it will be absorbed by water and calorimeter. So you won't understand this principle because we have not seen the procedure. So we'll see the procedure and we'll again come to the principle part. But you should know that here we are burning some known quantity of fuel in the calorimeter, in this bomb calorimeter, and then whatever the amount of heat will be released, that is assumed that the all the amount of heat is gained by water which is present in the calorimeter or which is present in this device. So whatever the amount of heat is produced, that is absorbed by water, and that is the main theme or that is the principle. It means here it is assumed that there is no any heat loss. Okay, so we'll see. The important part is the diagram. Just understand the diagram very carefully. This is the bomb calorimeter. तो हमें ये diagram draw करना है. So understand the diagram first. और ये diagram देख के आपको इसके construction parts बताना है. So there are four major parts in the diagram, so that you have to write. So let us see the diagram. This is the central pot known as bomb pot. This is generally stainless steel pot. In this we are taking the crucible. Crucible is a small dish like device in which known quantity of fuel is taken. Magnesium wire is touching to this electrode. It means these are the electrodes, this one and this one. These are the two electrodes which are connected to 6 volt DC battery. Okay, so this is the internal part as combustion chamber, we can say, or it can be considered as a bomb pot. Then this bomb pot is dipped in this water which is taken in the calorimeter. So this particular flask is considered to be a calorimeter. This can be a stainless steel or copper calorimeter in which we are taking known quantity of water, and here the stirrers are taken. So I will explain the role of stirrer in the working. And here there is a thermometer. It may be a digital or Beckman thermometer for measuring the temperature of water. So this is the second part. First part was the bomb pot, this one, center one. The second part is this combustion this calorimeter. Then third is, there are air jacket and water jackets. So what is air jacket and water jacket? Here there is a gap. Okay, you can see this is a gap and it is known as air jacket, and outside that again water jacket is taken. So the role of this air jacket and water jacket is to prevent the heat losses, if any, and that's why they are taken. And in the construction part, the fourth part is accessories. So which accessories are required here? So we require a 6 volt DC battery, we require oxygen cylinder. Oxygen cylinder is to be connected here, and it means this is the oxygen inlet valve, we can say, because we know here the fuel is taken. It means here we have to perform a combustion process. Yahan pe hume combustion start karna hai, combustion karna hai fuel ka. So in accessories we have to mention that 6 volt DC battery, oxygen inlet valve, then we can say pellet press may be there. Pellet press is nothing but, it is a device by which this fuel, if it is in the solid form, if it is in the powder form, that can be converted into a tablet like form, or we can say pellet form. So that can be a pellet press. So these are some subsidiary parts, or you can say secondary parts of the diagram or the instrument. So we'll see, we'll recall the terms in the construction part. First part is bomb pot, in which electrodes and fuse wire is taken and some crucible or cup is taken. So as we have seen, here it is the bomb pot, here it is the crucible, and here it is magnesium wire, okay, or we can say also called as fuse wire. The second part is calorimeter, that is water bath. It contains the thermometer, Beckman or digital thermometer, and stirrer is kept, in which water is taken, known quantity of water is taken, as we have seen in the diagram. Then air jacket and water jackets are there to prevent the heat losses, if any, and various accessories, maybe oxygen cylinder, pellet press, DC battery, etc. So the construction part is to be explained in very short. No much description is required for this in examination point of view, but still you should know and you should explain, you should write some part about the each points, the bomb pot, the calorimeter, air jacket, water jacket, and the accessories. I will explain the working with the diagram. So see, first of all, we have to take 10 to 15 ml of distilled water at the bottom of bomb pot. In this crucible, known amount of fuel, solid or liquid fuel, is taken. The fuel wire and the magnesium wire or fuse wire is kept touching to the electrode and the fuel. From this 6 volt DC battery, the voltage is applied or some current is applied so that the magnesium wire will get heated, it will burn, and it will ignite the fuel. The fuel will burn, and due to burning or due to combustion of fuel, this bomb pot, which is a stainless steel pot, will get heated, it will become hot. Then water which is surrounding to this bomb pot, which is present in the calorimeter, that will absorb the heat. It means whatever the heat is produced inside this bomb pot will be absorbed by water around this bomb pot and which is in the calorimeter. This stirrer is taken to maintain the temperature of water as uniform. With the help of this thermometer, we can measure the initial temperature of water and final temperature of water. And from the differences in the temperature, rise in temperature, by putting it in the formula, we can find out the gross calorific value of fuel. So this is the simple working of the instrument. Okay, I will explain again. This is the central bomb pot in which we are taking 10 to 15 ml of water, known quantity of fuel in the crucible, wire is touching, from 6 volt DC battery we are applying current, so the wire will get heated, magnesium wire will get heated, it will burn, it will produce heat, so fuel will ignite, fuel will burn, it will produce some heat. So jo bhi heat yahan pe produce hoga, so due to that the this bomb pot will get heated, or ye water jo rahega surrounding mein, ye water jo rahega, wo water will absorb the heat. So due to absorption of heat by water, the rise in temperature will be recorded by the thermometer, and from these values, rise in temperature, we can determine the gross calorific value of fuel. Now you may ask, what is about the other parameters? So here, this is the stand, which is non-conducting material. These are the just bases, or we can say stand is taken for the support to keep this flask. One more question is expected here from you, that why we have taken this water here, distilled water here. So the reason is, if your fuel contains nitrogen and sulfur as impurities, so nitrogen may convert into various nitrogen oxides and sulfur into sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxides, and if you are opening the lid, that will be harmful because that will cause damage to our respiratory system. So this should not be expelled, or this should not be released, these gases should not be released into atmosphere, and that's why we are taking water here, distilled water here, so that though gases will be formed, they will be heavy and they will dissolve in water here, and there will be formation of sulfuric acid and nitric acids. It means nitrogen and sulfur oxide gases will dissolve in water, and there will be formation of H2SO4 and nitric acid, and that's why we have taken here the distilled water. So finally, when there will be the maximum temperature will be reached, the system is allowed to cool naturally, and the rate of cooling is observed, and from these observations we can find out the gross calorific value. So by using this formula we can find out the GCV. Gross calorific value GCV is equal to L is equal to W plus W, capital W plus small w, into T2 minus T1 upon X, where the terms are given. This capital W is mass of water taken in the calorimeter, that should be in the gram. Small w is mass, it is water equivalent of calorimeter set actually. Capital W is mass of water taken in the calorimeter. Small w is water equivalent of calorimeter set. That values will be given. T2 minus T1 will be the rise in temperature, and X will be the amount of fuel or mass of fuel in gram. Here, if you have to find out the value of small w, that is water equivalent of calorimeter set, that can be determined by using a standard fuel whose calorific value will be known. It means if GCV of that fuel will be known, then only this particular parameter can be calculated by using the same formula by performing the same experiment. But just we have to use the fuels. Whose calorific value will be known, and we have to perform the experiment. We have to find out this value. This W will be obtained. T2 minus T1 will be determined, and X will be known. So from that, all the values will be known except the small W. So from rearranging the formula, we can find out the value of small W. You may have a doubt, or you may ask, you may think that how the unit is calorie per gram. Because this W is in the gram, this is in the gram, and this may be in the degree Celsius or in Kelvin, and this is in the gram. So how calorie comes here? Oh, so don't get confused. This is the derived formula, and in the derivation part, the specific heat of water is also considered. But as the derivation is not in the syllabus and that is not required to you, so that's why this part is not given here. But don't worry, this formula is right and the unit is also right. So remember that the unit is calorie per gram. When you are using bomb calorimeter, the formula is this and unit is calorie per gram. But this formula is not sufficient because there are some corrections in the formula. So we'll see what are the corrections. It means this formula is not accurate. There are some corrections in the formula needs to be modified. So the corrections are: first correction is fuse wire correction. What does it mean? You might remember that we have used fuse wire or magnesium wire which was touching to the electrode and the fuel in the crucible. It means that fuse wire is also burning and that is also producing some heat. It means water in the calorimeter is absorbing the total amount of heat, and that has also absorbed the heat which is produced here by the fuse wire. It means is fuse wire के कंबशन में जो भी हीट प्रोड्यूस हुआ था वो भी वाटर ने एब्सॉर्ब किया और उसका रिकॉर्ड हुआ राइज इन टेम्परेचर में. इसलिए हमें करेक्टेड फॉर्मूला लाने के लिए ये वैल्यू क्या करना पड़ेगा, सब्सट्रैक्ट करना पड़ेगा. इसलिए सो द फ्यूज वायर करेक्शन जो वैल्यू रहेगा दैट नीड्स टू बी सब्सट्रैक्टेड. गॉट इट. द नेक्स्ट करेक्शन इज कूलिंग करेक्शन. What is the cooling correction? As we are allowing the system to cool from high temperature to low temperature, that is getting cooled naturally. But when the system is being cooled from high temperature to low temperature, it means it is losing the heat, it is losing the energy. You can say how? Because system is at high temperature initially, or we can say it has reached to the higher temperature and the system is allowed to cool. It means it is losing that energy, losing that heat. So we are not using that heat. If we could use that heat, अगर हमें वो heat अगर use करते तो हमें और ज़्यादा फायदा होता. तो हम वो heat use नहीं कर पा रहे. So as we are not using that heat, or we are not able to use that heat which is being given out during the cooling, so that's why this cooling correction is considered from the rate of cooling as dT per minute. and cooling correction is termed as x into dt. This is the symbol used for, we can say, the cooling correction x into dt, and this should be added in the rise in temperature, because this much amount of correction needs to be added, because this amount of heat is getting wasted. So we could use that heat and we could add it into the final formula. And one more correction is the acid correction. हमने देखा था कि बॉम्ब पॉट के बॉटम में हमने 10 to 15 नंबर ऑफ डिस्टिल वाटर लिया था, तो अगर उसमें सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड बनता है और सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड का वाटर के साथ रिएक्शन होके H2SO4 बनता है. सिमिलरली नाइट्रोजन, इफ इट इज देयर नाइट्रोजन एंड ऑक्सीजन अलॉन्ग विथ वाटर दैट आर फॉर्मिंग नाइट्रिक एसिड, इट मीन्स दिस सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड एंड नाइट्रिक एसिड रिएक्शंस विच आर फॉर्म, दीज रिएक्शंस आर एक्सोथर्मिक रिएक्शंस, इट मीन्स लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ हीट इज इवॉल्व. सो एक्चुअली हियर द डेल्टा एच ऑफ दिस रिएक्शंस आर गिवन, नो नीड टू रिमेंबर दिस वैल्यूज, बट जस्ट वी शुड नो दैट these are the exothermic reactions. It means the heat is evolved out during the formation of these acids. It means the water which has absorbed the heat from the bomb pot, that has also absorbed the heat which is liberated from this acid formation. इसका मतलब ये acid formation में जो भी heat तैयार हुआ था, जो भी heat produce हुआ था, वो भी वहाँ पे water ने absorb किया और rise in temperature में record किया गया. लेकिन ये जो हीट है ये एसिड फॉर्मेशन का ही रही है, फ्यूल का हीट नहीं है. तो सो एज टू गेट द करेक्ट फार्मूला, सो एज टू गेट द एक्यूरेट फार्मूला, दिस एसिड करेक्शन वैल्यू नीड्स टू बी सब्सट्रैक्टेड. सो द एसिड करेक्शन वैल्यू नीड्स टू बी सब्सट्रैक्टेड, एंड दैट्स वाई द फाइनल फार्मूला विल बी एल, दैट इज HCV, दैट इज GCV, दैट इज हायर कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू और ग्रॉस कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू इज इक्वल टू W प्लस W इंटू T2 माइनस T1 प्लस दिस T into dt is cooling correction, and minus what we are subtracting, A for acid correction and F for fusel correction. So we are subtracting this A and F, acid correction and fusel correction, and divided by X, that is amount of fuel or the mass of fuel, and the unit is calorie per gram. These are some of the standard fuels whose calorific values are known, and this can be useful for determination of water equivalent of calorimeter set. मैंने पहले फॉर्मूले में बताया था कि अगर हमें स्मॉल डब्ल्यू का वैल्यू फाइंड आउट करना है तो हमें एक हद फ्यूल लेना पड़ेगा एज अ स्टैंडर्ड फ्यूल हुज कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू विल बी नॉन, और फिर हमें एक्सपेरिमेंट करना पड़ेगा. ऑल अदर वैल्यूज कैन बी डिटरमाइन एक्सपेरिमेंटली, एंड द GCV इज टू बी टेकन फ्रॉम द लिटरेचर वैल्यू. सो इन दिस वे द वैल्यू ऑफ स्मॉल डब्ल्यू, दैट इज वाटर इक्वलेंट ऑफ कैलोरीमीटर सेट, कैन बी डिटरमाइन if required.